Sometimes a character seems to just be getting going when they are snatched from our screens as quickly as they appeared. Whether for the shock factor or to try and change up the perceived stale dynamic of a show, these deaths often surprise and stun viewers. A tried and tested trope of modern television, it is a shock moment like this that can get people talking or sometimes turn a once loyal audience away completely. Any death feels hard to swallow when we are really getting to know a character, but it can be downright impossible to take when it feels like these characters had so much more to give us. Uncompleted arcs, unfinished business, and unfillable voids are all that is left when a character meets their premature end, and it can be completely gut-wrenching. I am the Peking Ash from What Culture, and these are 10 TV characters killed right in their prime. 10. Mike, Breaking Bad. Gruff hitman Mike was a bona fide fan favourite when he was so cruelly ripped from our screens. And although it was an unfortunate event that took place in the final season of the show, it always felt as if Mike had so much more to give to Breaking Bad. Mike was something of a slow burner, an interesting character who seemed happy to sit in the background and get sh** done. But as the seasons piled up, Mike's deceptive sensitivity and mentoring of Jesse endeared him to us all. A testament to Vince Gilligan's ability to write truly great and interesting characters, Mike constantly surprised and impressed us with his sadly limited screen time. It felt like we were only just getting to know the real Mike when he was needlessly gunned down by an increasingly unstable Walter. God bless Better Call Saul for giving us all that Mike fix that we so desperately needed after Breaking Bad ended. 9. Stringer Bell, The Wire. Stringer Bell was a hugely influential character in HBO's pinnacle of television, The Wire. He set so many of the show's biggest plot points in motion and was a constant enigma, who never quite sat fully on either side of the war on the streets. Not quite a gangster and not quite a businessman, but somewhere in between, Stringer was a volatile and unpredictable character who kept the audience on their toes. A seemingly remorseless but wildly ambitious man, played by the always magnetic Idris Elba, Stringer's efforts and plans finally seemed to be coming to a head when he was killed off from the show. Bell was a constant advocate for legitimizing, and such a future was finally in reach for him when his past actions finally caught up to him and he was poetically gunned down in one of his own unfinished lots. A man of seemingly endless cunning, there is little doubt Stringer had much more to give before Omar finally came a-calling. 8. Andrea, The Walking Dead. Like so many other characters in The Walking Dead, Andrea was someone who had survived so much that it gave us hope that she might make it out the other end alive. But it is The Walking Dead we're watching here, so of course, that is our own fault. Since we're all here, we of course know that this was not the case. Andrea survived just long enough to work her way into the hearts of The Walking Dead fans everywhere before biting the dust for good. Andrea proves to be a strong and independent character. Her admirable qualities seem to shine through in the most testing of circumstances. Although she allows the governor to live when given the opportunity to kill him, she redeems herself when given the chance. It seems at this point that Andrea's arc is well and truly back on track. And then The Walking Dead does what The Walking Dead does best. The fact that she came so close to escaping just made it all the more difficult to swallow. 7. Brody, Homeland. Homeland's first season exploded onto our screens some years back, and quickly garnered a reputation as one of the most exciting and tense shows on television. A large part of this deserved success was down to the powerfully believable performance of the fantastic Damian Lewis as Sergeant Nicholas Brody. Brody was a cripplingly conflicted character, and the perfect springboard for the show to chuck twist after twist at the audience. He was a character we sympathized with without ever fully understanding what he was going through, meaning we were never quite sure how he would behave. Lewis Brody made for constantly gripping TV. There can be little doubt that Homeland never managed to capture its early heights after ill-advisedly killing off Brody. Losing an actor of Lewis's caliber would hurt any show, and killing a character of Brody's depth would mean certain death for it. So it proved to be for Homeland. The show has recovered since then, but it looked touch and go for a long time. 6. Oberyn Martell, Game of Thrones. Oberyn Martell is Game of Thrones' great white that it so carelessly decided to jump over. Admittedly, the show had its fair share of stellar episodes after this seismic loss, like Battle of the Bastards and Hard Home for a couple of examples, but for the duration of season 4, Oberyn was the reason we were glued to our screens. Oberyn's unforgettable journey culminated with him absolutely wiping the floor with the previously insurmountable Man Mountain. Fist pumping on couches the world over, we we all watched as one final blow was about to be laid upon the stricken mountain. But then, Oberon was swept off his feet and had his head crushed like a grape, and we all suddenly remembered that we were watching Game of Thrones. Oberyn was a character with seemingly limitless potential, a free spirit from a foreign land as yet unexplored in any depth in the show. Sadly, a fact that is never truly remedied as it is skipped over like Oberyn's corpse in the streets of King's Landing. He was, in his unfairly limited time on screen, the best part of the show, and one feels that he would only have added to that reputation given more time. 5. Cutner House. Dr. Lawrence Cutner was a high point in a show of somewhat diminishing quality by the time that he appeared on our screens. House had been a fantastic original take on the medical drama for a few seasons before a change of supporting cast in an attempt to freshen it up somewhat diluted its undoubted quality. However, Cutner, of all people, proved to be a new addition that allowed the show to continue as a thoroughly entertaining watch. An intelligent and caring presence, Cutner often clashed with House and even managed to prove him wrong from time to time. He was a perfect foil for the show's surly lead, and it therefore came as some surprise when Cutner killed himself in the 5th season of the show. The show was already wavering under the pressure it seemed to feel trying to replace its original cast, and without one character that seemed to succeed in their attempts to do so, it never returned to the lofty heights it had once scaled. 4. Tony Blundetto, The Sopranos. Steve Buscemi is one of the most distinct and distinguished actors working today, so it would stand to reason that any show, even one as consistently brilliant as The Sopranos, would miss someone of his ilk after he's gone. But especially when his character also happens to be one of the highlights of the season he features in. As Tony Soprano's cousin, Tony Blundetto, Buscemi proved to be an endearing and wildly likable presence that only added to the show's already well-established brilliance. His volatile nature, of course, always made him a prime contender for an early exit from the show, but it still felt like it was taken away too soon. Tony was killed by his mob boss cousin, and we were all undoubtedly remiss to not have seen more of him. The Sopranos is a show with many memorable deaths throughout its run, and many that seemed to come out of nowhere, but it certainly felt like we were only at the beginning of Tony's story when that bullet struck. 3. Cottonmouth, Luke Cage. Considering their current run, it is tough to say that Marvel have made many mistakes with their properties recently. But the death of Cornell Cottonmouth Stokes in Luke Cage certainly feels like one of their bigger missteps. Not least because it stripped the show of standout talent and multiple Oscar winner Mahershala Ali, but also because he was a deeply intriguing and original villain. One of the strangest elements of this one comes in the fact that the episode before he is so pointlessly tossed through a window, we are actually given an episode dedicated almost entirely to Cottonmouth's backstory. We're given a glimpse into what makes and motivates the man, and we are all the more intrigued by him for it. It feels like a deeply wasted opportunity, not the least of all considering the drastic drop in quality the rest of the show suffered after. The opening half of Luke Cage was as strong as anything Marvel had done, and it owed so much of that to a well-written, believable villain acted by a man at the peak of his powers. There can be no doubt the show would have thrived with his continued presence. 2. Charlie, Lost. Lost was a show not shy about killing off its characters, but none felt quite so cruel or as sudden as the fate of fan favourite Charlie Pace. A troubled musician with a drug dependency, it wasn't long before Charlie's fervent behaviour was replaced with a kind and warm soul that had audiences tuning in weekly. This made it all the more difficult for audiences to accept watching the water swirl around Charlie behind that locked door. His heroic end wasn't enough to stop the show hemorrhaging viewers disgusted with having Dominic Monaghan's Charlie taken away from them. The show would eventually recover, of course, and go on to be one of the most popular shows of all time, but a dark cloud of what could have been with Charlie Pace always seemed to be hanging over it. 1. Rita, Dexter. Many fans point to one moment as the steep decline of the show about your friendly neighborhood serial killer, Dexter. And that moment is the death of his wife, Rita. Coming out of seemingly nowhere at the end of the show's unparalleled season 4, Rita's death shocked fans to the core. Serving as a secondary character for much of the show's early run, Rita soon began to develop with increased screen time, and as such, became a perfect antithesis to Dexter's double life. An honest and caring character who grounded Dexter in his most vulnerable or distressing moment, Rita was not only a brilliant character in her own right, but one who Dexter seemingly needed. An early end didn't seem to be on the cards for a character getting stronger and stronger with each passing season. But alas, that is what became of Rita. The image of Dexter cradling his young child in a bathroom covered in his wife's blood is one which will stick with audiences as vividly as Rita could have, given the opportunity. And that's our list. Which of these characters deserve better? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. I've been Ash, and this has been What Culture. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and come back again soon for some more deadly TV content. Thanks for watching.